journey through salvation history to witness the origin of God's love for all mankind, made known to us by Jesus in the Holy Eucharist. Throughout his papacy, Pope John Paul II proclaimed the deep and abiding truth that the Eucharist is at the very center of the Church's life. From calling the faithful throughout the world to a new evangelization, to drawing millions of young people closer to the faith by establishing World Youth Day, Pope John Paul II led countless souls closer to our Lord through the celebration of this sacred mystery. In honor of Pope John Paul II's lifetime of service and sacrifice, the Poor Clare Nuns of Perpetual Adoration have brought Mother Angelica's vision to life, creating a place where people of all faiths can come and learn more about the precious treasure of the Holy Eucharist. Come now and experience for yourself this journey from the covenant with Israel to the covenant in Christ Jesus. Through church history, the saints, and the source and summit of all we believe, the Holy Eucharist. We hope your visit today enriches your spiritual life and strengthens your faith.
Because of the Father, so he who eats me will live because of me. This is the bread which came down from heaven, not such as the fathers ate and died. He who eats this bread will live forever.
This he said in the synagogue as he taught at Capernaum. Many of his disciples, when they heard it, said, "This is a hard saying. Who can listen to it?" But Jesus, knowing in himself that his disciples murmured at it, said to them,
"Do you take offense at this? And what have you to see the Son of Man ascending where he was before? It is the Spirit that gives life. The flesh is of no avail. The words that I have spoken to you are spirit and life, but there are some of you that do not believe."
For Jesus knew from the first who those were that did not believe, and who it was that should betray him. And he said,
"This is why I told you that no one can come to me unless it is granted him by the Father."
After this, many of his disciples drew back and no longer went about with him. Jesus said to the 12,
"Will you also go away?"
Simon Peter answered him, "Lord, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life."
Lord, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. Jesus lost most of his disciples that day. And he said this in the synagogue. Late in his public ministry, he had already healed the lepers, cured the blind, raised the dead, and most of those people that left him that they had seen that. And yet when he told them that they had to eat his flesh and drink his blood, they couldn't understand. Try to place yourself in their place. We have had the benefit of religious instruction most of our lives. This is not the first time you've heard this, but it was the first time that they heard it. This is difficult to accept and to understand. But we always have a choice. Whether we understand or not is not a requirement to choose to follow and love God. You don't have to understand everything he's doing. And most of his disciples made a choice to leave him. Because they couldn't understand. And when he turned to Peter, his closest friends, he said, "Are you going to go too?" Peter's response was not, "Oh, yes, Lord, no problem. I'm with you all the way, 100%. It was a complete surrender. "Where else am I going to go? We have come to believe that you are the Christ. Where else am I going to go?" But they made a different choice. They chose to continue to follow God. They loved him, and they wanted to be with him. And so they continued to follow him because they loved him. And they knew that he loved them. So let's keep that in mind as we continue. Majestic. That lamb did not have his life taken from him. That lamb freely gives his life so that we might have life. But the lamb has to be killed. As we're going to see in a minute, the lamb has to be slain. So there's a hole in his chest, in his heart. And you see the blood and water flowing out of it, which is just a piece of red glass with water flowing over the red glass. But it's flowing into the chalice, which Catholics partake of at every Mass. Whether you drink from it or not, if you receive communion, you receive the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. So his blood is flowing into the chalice, and that artist in Italy decided to depict the whole world by just sculpting the Jerusalem skyline. So that's what you see here in this part, is the city of Jerusalem. It is intended to represent the whole world. And this part of the statue is the outer court of the temple, which doesn't exist anymore. It was torn down in a war. But when it was there, it was the only place that Jews could come and sacrifice for atonement for their sins. And so we have the blood of the Lamb flowing through the chalice, over the whole world and out the temple, the Jewish temple, where those sacrifices were actually happening in Jesus. And we're just so blessed to have it. It is truly a beautiful representation. The book is in here. The next video is going